Geology is the study of planet Earth, its history, and all the processes that act on it. Hydrogeology is the branch of geology which studies how water and rocks interact underground, mainly in aquifers. An aquifer is a rock unit that can hold enough water to supply water to wells. Aquifers can be found in many types of rocks, including sandstone, conglomerate, unconsolidated sand and gravel, and fractured rocks composed of limestone or igneous rocks. Here, at Barton Springs in Austin, Texas, we're standing on top of the Edwards Aquifer, composed mostly of fractured limestone. Over time, these fractured rocks can dissolve to create large, cave-like systems called karst aquifers. So when you hear the word karst, think cave. Some of these caves are big, some of them are small. Karst aquifers are different from sedimentary aquifers, where water mostly flows through gravel and sand grains, similar to a sponge. Hydrogeologists use two terms when investigating aquifers: porosity and permeability. Porosity is all the empty pore space inside a rock given in a percent volume. Porosity represents the volume of water a rock formation can potentially hold. Permeability is how well a fluid can flow within the pore spaces of the rock within the aquifer. For water, we describe this property as hydraulic conductivity. For example, clay and rocks like pumice often have high porosity, but because their pores do not connect well with each other, they are often low in permeability. Low permeability materials, such as clay and shale, typically act as barriers to groundwater flow and may often function as an aquitard in groundwater flow systems. Aquifers that are bounded on the top and bottom by aquitards are called confined aquifers. In confined aquifers, the groundwater is under pressure. If penetrated by a well, the water level in a confined aquifer will rise above the top of the aquifer. In some cases, the water will reach the surface, resulting in a flowing or artesian well. Confined aquifers function differently than unconfined aquifers, which have no overlying aquitard. Unconfined aquifers occur near the Earth's surface, so they may interact better to the processes that occur near or above land surface. Because unconfined aquifers are exposed to the atmosphere, they may interact with surface water features, such as rivers or lakes. If the water level in the aquifer is higher than in the adjacent rivers or lakes, the rivers or lakes gain water. In other words, water from the aquifer flows into the rivers or lakes. If the water level in the aquifer is lower than in the rivers or lakes, then the rivers or lakes lose water. That's saying that water flows from the rivers or lakes into the aquifer. Rainwater may infiltrate the shallow soil and enter the aquifer. Plant roots may extend down into the aquifer and use the water to survive. Groundwater close to the Earth's surface may also evaporate. Hydrogeologists use the terms recharge and discharge to describe how water enters and leaves an aquifer. One way an aquifer can discharge is through a spring. Springs occur when the water table intersects the land surface. The Barton Springs pool is fed by this spring here. Notice the large fracture which the water flows out of. Here, at Upper Barton Spring, water is flowing out of the ground from a karst aquifer, or small caves. To understand better how aquifers work, many hydrogeologists and scientists develop physical models. To see the physical model in action, continue on to part 2.